Morning everyone, welcome back to another fossil hunting video. I've come out to one of my local beaches again. It's 5 a.m. in the morning. It's going to be an absolute corker of a day, I reckon. So I've just come onto a section of the beach where there's quite a few pebbles exposed. So I'm going to have a quick look around to see if there's anything interesting that catches my eye. So I've just come across this very interesting looking rock here. I'm gonna try and wedge it out of the sand and see if there's anything on the other side. Might be a bit of fossil bone, or it could just be nothing on it. But I'm gonna go ahead and get it out. Whoops. So on this occasion, it looks like there was nothing else inside. But it's always worth getting out these types of rocks. So I just picked these three interesting looking nodules from a fresh cliff fall back there. I'm going to go ahead and crack them open now. There's definitely an ammonite inside this one, but it's extremely crushed. But it's worth splitting open just in case it pops well. I'm going to pop that one first. A few light taps and it's already opened. Oh wow. That popped so easy and it's perfect on the inside. What a brilliant start. Time for the second one. There's a nice looking crack. In fact, I can already see another ammonite on the inside of this one. So we could have hit a bit of good luck here, and I'm hoping it will just pop open like that. There's another ammonite in, but it is very poorly preserved. Now it's time for this absolute corker. Let's hope for a perfect ammonite on the inside. Uh-oh. There was an ammonite in, but there was a natural fracture. That is pretty much a big shame, but always a chance. Ah, what a shame. If you are interested in purchasing your own fossil from the Yorkshire coast, please check out my website called buyafossil.com. There's a bunch of really nice ammonite specimens and quite a bit of fossil bone up for sale. I really appreciate everyone who's gone ahead and bought some really nice fossils in the past. So I've just been walking along this part of the beach here and I spotted this huge nodule laying in this rock pool. When I turn it over, I notice there's a little harpocerous ammonite sticking out. As much as I'd love to bring this back in one piece, I'm gonna have to try and crack it open and see if I can break it down a little bit, because I'm quite far away from my car and I'm not gonna be able to carry this big pyrite nodule back. So I've just managed to knock the little harpo off, so at least I can take this bit back. I know a lot of people would have preferred it in that huge nodule, but there's just no chance. Okay everyone, so it's now the day after the video that you've just watched. I didn't find much yesterday, but hopefully today will be better. It's been a pretty decent tide today. You can probably see the marks where the tide line has been. So it's had a good wash over all the rocks. So let's try and get his eye in and see if we can spot any nice ammonite nodules. So there's a decent dactylosaurus inside here. You can see the keel, which is already worn out. That'll be a nice one once prepared.
something a little bit different for you here. This super pyritic rock here is full of gyrosteous fish bone, possibly from the fin. Pretty cool piece, quite common along the Yorkshire coast though.
So there's potentially a really good one here. I can already see the keel. Very nice, that's a complete dactylosaurus ammonite inside there. Super pyritic,
but it should be a complete and really nice example once prepared.
A piece of fossilized wood, which is being washed up along the tide line. Look at that absolute belter. A beautiful golden keel sticking out of the rock.
Wow, that's an absolute corker. It's also got a natural cut base, brilliant.
So there's plenty more rocks to look through here, but I'm gonna continue heading on further because I want to get to a different section of the beach, and then I can always have a look here on the way back.
A nice piece of rock here with lots of tiny little ammonites preserved on it. Lovely little dactylosaurus grey sails there. I've just found this massive nodule with a really nice dack in it. The dack is right there. I'm going to leave this piece here and then I'll pick it up on the way back. But I have just picked up my first piece of marine reptile bone in ages. So I'm guessing it's a piece of paddle section, probably from a plesiosaur or maybe a really large ichthyosaur. Very nice, only a small little bit. I believe I've had some more of this in the past, about 2 years ago. It looks pretty similar, but I'm very happy with that because it's been a bit of a bone dry streak at the moment.
There was a big outer whirl of one, but the rest of it is unfortunately long gone. I'm gonna leave that piece, I think. Could this be an ammonite? Let's go ahead and crack it open and find out. And there we have it, a harpocerous ammonite. So now it's time to crack open these nodules here. I have just picked this really crushed tenicostatum nodule up, so let's see if it pops. Very crushed around here, but you never know, sometimes they pop well. And then there's this really nice looking nodule with a keel poking out that I picked up at the very start of the fossil hunt. I'm hoping this will pop well.
It's popped a bit of the outer keel off there. Definitely doesn't want to pop. I think I'm going to have to take this one back and have it prepared and it'll be a beauty. Best not to risk damaging it when it's a perfect specimen. So I've just popped that tenicostatum nodule as well, and the middle wasn't preserved very well. It's pretty much just an impression, but it's popped well.
So that's the end of the video. Hopefully you've enjoyed it, and I'll see you all on the next one.